Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and this is a bit different video, and in this video you will see how you can create your own VPN server for free. There are tons of free VPN available, but they are limited by speed and data usage. So you can create your own VPN and use it for free for 1 year. To create a VPN server, you need to have a cloud server where you can deploy your VPN software. For that, we are going to use a cloud server and a free VPN software called OpenVPN. There are different companies that provide cloud server like DigitalOcean, Linode, AWS. But if you create an account and create a droplet or create a server on DigitalOcean, you have to pay at least $6 per month. But we want to create a free VPN. For that, we need to have a free cloud server. The solution is AWS, that is Amazon Web Services free tier. AWS provides free tier for different services on their platform. Now we need Amazon EC2 free tier. EC2 is Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud. So we need to create a server on EC2. You can see that it has 12 month free tier. So you have to create an account on AWS. Just create a free account and provide your details. You have to provide your credit and or debit card detail. Don't worry, it won't charge anything apart from authentication fee. Follow the on-screen instruction to create account. It is quite easy to create an account on AWS. Once you are done, you need to log in into AWS console. I already have an account with AWS and I am logged into the AWS management console. Now the first thing you should do is check the region where your Amazon AWS server is located. If you want an US IP for your VPN, then select the US region. Or if you want any Asian country, then select Asia Pacific region or any other region where you want your VPN to point. Once you have right region selected, you need to look for EC2. Click on this services and select EC2, or you can simply search for EC2 in this search box. EC2 virtual server in the cloud. Click on this option. Now you will get this kind of interface and you won't have any instance running. The cloud server in AWS are called instance, so you have to create a new instance. Click on this launch instances. And these are the basic servers. Some servers you don't have to select it. Just click on AWS marketplace and search for OpenVPN. So that we can install OpenVPN software automatically. You don't have to install it manually. Once you search for OpenVPN, you will get these options. And here you need to select OpenVPN access server, not any other option. Don't select these options, select OpenVPN access server and click on select. And here you will get some pricing detail for different instances on AWS. But it has free tier eligible. So just look for this free tier eligible. If it is eligible, then don't worry, you just have to click on continue. Now select this t2.micro which has free tier eligible. In your region, this may be different, but look for free tier eligible only and select that instance. Once you have selected, click on review and launch. Click on the launch option again. Don't worry about anything else. Click on launch again. Now you need to create a key pair. You won't have any existing key pair, so create a new key pair. Click on this option and name the key pair anything, whatever you want, and download the key pair. This is the only time you can download this key pair, so download it and keep it safe. If you lose it, it is gone forever. You won't be able to download it again. So keep this pemfile.pem file safe. And then click on launch instances. Now it will take some time to create your cloud server on AWS and install OpenVPN software. Once it is done, you will see this message, your instances are now launching. You don't have to worry about these things. Now click on this instance ID to open the created instance, that is server. Now it is currently pending. I will wait for some time and refresh it. And now the server is running. Here are some information about server. Click on your instance ID again. You should see this kind of page, and here you can connect your server so that we can execute some commands. Click on connect option. Now we want to use SSH client to connect with our server, not any other option. So click on SSH client and you will get some details about your server. Here are some commands listed which we will use to connect with our server. So first you need to open SSH client. If you are on Mac, you can open terminal. If you are on Windows PC, then you can open CMD or PowerShell as admin. So right now I am on the Mac, so I will open terminal here. Process is same on the Windows PC as well. You just have to open PowerShell. Now here are some commands listed which you need to execute on the terminal or PowerShell to connect with your server. First you need to copy this command which says ssh-i, then your .pem file, username root, and the public DNS of your created instance. Copy this command exactly. Now paste it on the terminal or PowerShell on Windows machine. Now you have to locate the downloaded .pem file. So you have to provide the path where downloaded file is located. I am already inside my user account on this terminal. So I have to provide the location for downloaded file. So delete this code and type download then /. If you have downloaded that file on any other location like documents or desktop, then you have to provide that path. After that, hit enter on your keyboard. Now it is asking, are you sure you want to continue connecting? Type yes and hit enter on your keyboard. Now I am getting an error here that .pem file has bad permissions. It is required that your private key files are not accessible by others. So we have to change the permission for downloaded .pem file. For that, I need to copy another command from AWS interface to change the permission for downloaded .pem file. So copy this command and paste it on the terminal and provide the exact path of the downloaded .pem file. So I will type downloads since it is in my download folder. Downloads /. Then .pem file, then hit enter. So it will change the permission of that .pem file to read only. Once it is done, you have to execute that command again, previous command. You can press up arrow key on your keyboard to get that command on the terminal or CMD. So it is good now, and then press enter on your keyboard. It will take some time to connect with your server. Then here you have to type yes, then hit enter on your keyboard. Then press enter on your keyboard to set things as default. Please enter the optional number of the list above default, enter. Then specify the port number, enter. Specify the TCP port, enter. Should client traffic be routed by default through VPN? We have to create yes option. So type yes, then hit enter. You can change this setting from the backend as well. Should client DNS traffic be routed by default through VPN? Yes. Then hit enter and then enter for this default option. Press enter for default subnet. Do you wish to log in to the admin UI as OpenVPN? Hit enter to yes. And this OpenVPN is going to be your username. So you have to remember this. Hit enter for yes. Please specify your activation key or leave it empty. Enter and enter. Now you have to log in to your server as OpenVPN AS rather than root. Earlier we logged in using root user account. Now we will log in as OpenVPN AS. So let's log in back to the server using the new user. So you have to get that command again on the terminal or CMD, then change this root to OpenVPN AS. Just delete the root username and type there OpenVPN AS. Then hit enter on your keyboard. Now you will be connected to your server as OpenVPN AS username. Once you are logged in, you need to change the password for OpenVPN username. That is the backend UI admin username, not the OpenVPN AS username. OpenVPN AS username is to connect with your server. So type sudo passwd then space OpenVPN then hit enter. Now type a new password. You won't be able to see the password, so confirm the password, then hit enter on your keyboard. Now the password is updated. Now everything is done on the terminal or CMD. Let's go back to the AWS console and click on your instance, that is server, then copy this public IP address. Now open the new tab on the browser, type https://, then paste your public IP, then :943, that is port number, then /, then admin. Hit enter on your keyboard. Now you will see this your connection is not private error message. If you can continue by going to advanced option, then good. I think Chrome is acting too secure on the Mac. So I will copy this URL and open it on the Firefox. So let's go to this URL and admin. Again, same warning. I will proceed, accept the risk and continue. Now you will see OpenVPN access server admin login page. Type your username, which is OpenVPN if you haven't changed it, and the password which you created in the last step on the terminal. Then click on sign in and agree to the term and conditions. Then you will see backend of OpenVPN access server. You can connect two clients for VPN. Then go to VPN settings. Actually, you don't have to change anything if you have followed all the steps on the terminal, because we have changed some settings already. So you have to make sure this routing, should a client internet traffic be routed through VPN, should be yes. And this option should be yes also. Then save the changes. But if you have done all the things as I did, then you don't need to do anything on the backend of OpenVPN. Now let's go to another tab and type the same thing but delete the admin. So https IP address, then port number 943, then hit enter on your keyboard. Now this is the front end of OpenVPN. Type the same username and password. Hit sign in. Now you will get options to download the clients for your device. The client is available for Mac, Windows, Linux, Android and iOS devices. So I am on the Mac, so I will download the Mac client. Download the app according to your operating system. It is downloading. Let's install it. Continue and then close. Okay, let's open the OpenVPN Connect app. And you don't have to do anything. You don't have to configure it because your profile would be imported. So it has imported my profile. And you have to turn on the VPN, provide the username and password, same username and password, to log in to the OpenVPN Connect app. Now I am connected to my VPN server on my device. So you can see that it has connected to the VPN server. How to check it? Let's Google it. My IP location on Google. Open this URL, you can see it is showing my IPv4, which is the IP address of the created server. The ISP is amazon.com and region is Virginia, United States, because I created that server on Virginia region in the United States. So this way you can create your own VPN server on the cloud using Amazon AWS, and you can create multiple instances on the free tier. So if you want to connect 4 devices on another region, launch another instance, free instance, and create your own VPN server on that region. And if you continue using it after 12 months, then you have to pay for it. Otherwise, you can delete your instances before 12 months. And here's a pro tip. If you want to make a career in IT without learning much coding, then learn AWS. Learn how to create server, how to manage server, how to deploy servers, how to deploy Kubernetes, how to use Dockers. There are much more things to learn on this AWS platform. You can join some courses on Udemy or Coursera. There are tons of helpful courses there. So join it and get started. And this AWS thing is high demand in the IT sector. And that's all for this video, guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. And I will see you in my next video.